Students, I am Suresh Kumar. In this video, we are continuing with the principles of marginal costing from the last session. In the previous video, I was telling you the basics of marginal costing. There we defined what is marginal cost, which is the additional cost to be incurred for an extra production, and it is nothing but the aggregate of variable cost. Aggregate means it is the variable cost of material, that is direct material cost, direct labor cost, and other variable overheads. And the marginal costing is the division of, or the process of dividing the total cost into variable cost and fixed cost, because this marginal costing is a decision making process in which the decisions are based on contribution, where contribution is nothing but selling price minus variable cost per unit, or it is the sales, total sales value minus total variable cost. Therefore, in order to arrive at any decision under marginal costing principles, we will be able to divide the total cost into variable cost and fixed cost. And thereafter, we have been going through various formulae. There we defined what is contribution. Contribution is sales minus variable cost. And why contribution is so called? Because the total fixed cost remains constant. It is the contribution that determines what is the profit. Then PV ratio or profit volume ratio. It is contribution by sales into 100. Then what is break-even point? Break-even point is total fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. That will give you break-even sales in units. When you divide the total fixed cost by PV ratio, you will get the break-even point in value. Then we studied the margin of safety as actual sales minus break-even sales. And we also studied the formula to determine what is the sales to earn a required profit, which is equal to total fixed cost plus desired profit, all divided by PV ratio if you want to determine it in unit. And if you want to determine in value, it should be total fixed cost plus desired profit, all divided by PV ratio. And we did one question to compute this PV ratio, break-even point, margin of safety, and sales to earn a desired profit. Now let's go through second question. The problem is, the cost sheet of a company is given as follows. Selling price is 100 rupees, and thereafter the cost structure is given. Material cost is 30, labor cost is 30 rupees, and total overheads is 30 rupees. And in the case of labor cost 30 rupees, of this 30 rupees, 30% is fixed, that is balance is variable. And in the case of overheads, 70% of this 30 rupees is fixed and balance is variable. And the total cost is 30 plus 30 plus 30, 90, and the profit is 100 minus 90, 10 rupees per unit as per the given data. And the current production is, production and sales level is 1000 units. Normally, we studied in the assumptions of marginal costing, all the units or production is equal to sales to arrive at the decisions under marginal costing. Therefore, current production and sales level is 1000 units per annum. Now, question number 1, prepare marginal cost statement for 1000 boxes or units and 2000 units. Question number 2, if the marginal cost of the product is reassessed at 90 rupees, what should be the revised selling price to retain the same PV ratio? Therefore, you should prepare marginal cost statement for 1000 units and 2000 units. and you should find out what is the present PV ratio, and thereafter you will be find the new selling price so that the present PV ratio should be retained. First, marginal cost statement for 1000 units, particulates 1 unit and total volume, that is 1000 units. First, sales, it is selling price is 100 rupees, it is sales in rupees, it is 100, and 100 multiplied with volume, that is 100 times this production level, that is 1 lakh rupees. Then variable cost. This variable cost is given component wise. What is the material cost, what is the labor cost, and what is the variable over it. And first, direct or material, per unit material cost is 30 rupees. Why it is variable? It is varying with respect to production. That is, where variable cost per unit is given, convert it into total variable cost by multiplying with the respective volume. Therefore, this 30 is multiplied with volume. 30 into multiplied with production, that is 1000 units, is equal to 30,000. It is given that the labor cost per unit is 30, of which 30% is fixed. Therefore, what is the variable portion? In marginal costing, we will be able to divide the cost into variable cost and fixed cost. This total labor cost should be divided into variable labor portion and fixed portion. Labor, we may prepare a working note. Working note number 1, labor cost. Labor cost total is 30 rupees. Of this, 30% is fixed. Therefore, this should be divided into variable and fixed. Variable is 70%, fixed is 30%. Therefore, 30 into 70%, that is 21 rupees is variable, and 9 rupees is fixed. Therefore, what is the variable portion of labor? It should be 21. It is per unit in 21. This 21 should be multiplied with 1000 units, that is 21,000 rupees. Similarly, overhead, total overhead is 30 rupees, of which 70% is fixed. Therefore, you may consider what is the variable overhead. Prepare another working note number 2. Overheads total is 30 rupees, of which 30% is variable and 70% is fixed. Therefore, 30 into 30, that is 9 rupees per unit is the variable portion of overhead, and balance for 70%, 21 rupees per unit is the fixed portion of overhead. Therefore, variable overhead is 9 rupees per unit, and 9 multiplied with the production, 1000, that is 9000 is the total variable overhead. Now we can find out what is the total variable cost per unit. It is 60 rupees per unit, and total variable cost is 60,000 rupees. Now we have total sales and total variable cost. Therefore, in the third step, we can find out what is the contribution. Contribution is sales minus variable cost, that is step 1 minus step 2. Step 1, it is 100 minus 60, that is 40 rupees per unit. Contribution per unit is 40 rupees per unit, or total contribution, it is either 40 into this production 1000, 40,000, or it can otherwise be 1 lakh minus 60,000. Both will give you the same answer. It is 1 lakh minus 60,000, that is 40,000 less. Fourth step, total fixed cost. We have fixed cost per unit, that is 9 rupees in the case of labor, and fixed cost per unit 21 from the total variable overheads. Then first we can find out what is the fixed cost per unit. Working note number 3, fixed cost. First, what is the fixed cost per unit? Fixed cost per unit from the labor, there is 9 rupee labor plus 21 rupees from overheads. Therefore, fixed cost per total fixed cost per unit is 30 rupees per unit. Now, what is the total fixed cost? Where fixed cost per unit is given in the question, convert it into total fixed cost by multiplying it with the appropriate production level. Therefore, total fixed cost is equal to fixed cost per unit into volume. Now we are preparing it is for 1000 units, therefore it should be 30 rupees per unit into production, 1000 units, which is equal to 30,000 rupees. Therefore, total fixed cost, we will not take anything under per unit, because that is how the assumptions of marginal costing are taken. That is, total fixed cost remains constant irrespective of volume. We are not considering anything as fixed cost per unit. Therefore, this 30,000 alone should be considered, and it should be considered only below the total of the company, 30,000, resulting in profit of, that is step 5, profit is equal to step 3 minus step 4. What is step 3? Contribution. This step 3 minus step 4. Therefore, it should be 40,000 minus 30,000 rupees, which is equal to 10,000 rupees. The second part of the first question, prepare the marginal cost statement for 2000 boxes, 2000 units. There the sales, apply the assumptions of marginal costing, where selling price per unit is given. Selling price per unit a constant, or total sales value varies directly proportional to volume. Therefore, selling price is 100 and it is multiplied with the 2000 box units, so that the total sales value is 2 lakh rupees. Then material cost, material, it is variable cost. What is a variable cost? Varying with respect to output. Therefore, 30 rupees is the material cost per unit. What is the total variable cost? 30 into volume, 2000, 60,000. Similarly, labor, please go back to the previous working note. 30 rupees is given as the total variable cost, of which 21 rupee is variable, that is 70% is variable. Therefore, 21 into 2000, 42,000. Similarly, total fixed cost is 30, and 30% is variable, that is 30 into 30% is 9 rupees per unit is the variable portion. This is multiplied with volume and you will get 18,000 as the total variable cost. Now, the total variable cost per unit, that is same as before, there is no change. There is the assumptions in marginal costing. Variable cost per unit remains constant irrespective of volume. Or total variable cost 60 into 2000, lakh and 20,000, or it should be 60 plus 42,000 plus 18,000. It is 1,20,000 is the total variable cost. Now, what is contribution? We have sales value and variable cost value. It is either selling price minus variable cost per unit, 100 minus 60, 40 is the contribution. Or total variable cost, total contribution is contribution per unit multiplied with volume 2000, 40 into multiplied with 2000, 80,000, or it should be total sales value minus total variable cost 2 lakh minus 1,20,000, which is equal to 80,000. Now what about fixed cost? In the previous question, when we prepared the marginal cost statement for 1000 units, please refer back to the computation of total fixed cost. We arrived at a total fixed cost per unit, that is 9 rupees from labor portion and 21 rupees from overhead portion. Therefore, total fixed cost per unit is 30, and that is multiplied with the volume 1000 units. Total fixed cost was 30,000. Now we are preparing for 2000 boxes. Now what is the assumption in marginal costing principle? Fixed cost remains constant irrespective of volume. The fixed cost for 1000 units and fixed cost for 2000 units are the same. This is one of the fundamental assumptions in marginal costing. Remember, this should be within the relevant range. That is, within the relevant range, fixed cost remains constant irrespective of volume. That is the important assumptions in marginal costing. Therefore, even for 2000 units of production, total fixed cost remains the same as 30,000, which is computed for 1000 units. This is very, very, very important application for your examination question. Where the question is silent on relevant range, or the question does not give any adjustment to recompute the fixed cost, you should understand the given range of 1000 unit should be the relevant range, and that will remain constant even for 2000 units unless otherwise stated in the question. This is one of the fundamental assumption in marginal costing. Fixed cost for 1000 units and fixed cost for 2000 units are the same. If there is any variation, that should be given separately in the question. Since the question is silent on changes in total fixed cost, you should understand the fixed cost for 1000 units will be same as that of 2000 units. Therefore, it should not be 30 rupees per unit into 2000 units, that is 60,000. Instead, it should remain as constant as 30,000 rupees, so that the profit is 80,000 minus 30,000, 50,000 rupees. This question is selected to you to understand a particular principle in marginal costing. It is very, very, very important. Where fixed cost per unit is given, convert it into total fixed cost. Why? Because we are concerned only about total fixed cost. Convert it into total fixed cost by multiplying it, that is per unit cost, with an appropriate base, that is the suitable base, that is the production level under consideration. Thereafter, once the total fixed cost is so arrived, it must be kept constant irrespective of volume. Very, very, very important. What is it? Where fixed cost per unit is given, convert it into total fixed cost by multiplying it with the respective volume. Thereafter, respective volume is the suitable base, which is applicable for the relevant range. Thereafter, that total fixed cost remains constant irrespective of volume. That is, you should understand, by applying the principles of marginal cost, the total fixed cost for 1000 units and 2000 units are the same unless otherwise specifically given some other adjustments. Now question number 2. If the marginal cost of the product is reassessed at 90 rupees, Marginal cost means variable cost. Reassessed at 90 rupees. What should be the revised selling price to retain the same profit volume ratio? The company is reassessed the marginal cost, that is variable cost. What is the marginal cost now? 60 rupees per unit. 60 rupees per unit is reassessed to 90 rupees. The company wants to increase the variable cost to 90 rupees, but they do not want to compromise on profit. That is, the PV ratio should not be changed. And now, what is the present PV ratio? Formula for PV ratio: contribution or contribution per unit divided by selling price into 100. That is present PV ratio. 40 divided by 100 rupees into 100. This 40 rupees by 100 rupees into 100. That is to convert it into percentage. This is equal to 40%. The present PV ratio is 40%. Even after the variable cost is increased to 90, the company wants to maintain the same 40%. And what is the selling price required to maintain the same PV ratio? Now, what is PV ratio? PV ratio is equal to contribution by sales into 100. This PV ratio is given, that is, it should be 0.4. And what is this contribution? Sales minus variable cost per unit, selling price minus variable cost per unit divided by selling price. Therefore, 0.4 should be equal to, and we need to find out what is this sales value. Therefore, it should be sales minus variable cost is reassessed to 90 rupees divided by sales should be computed. Therefore, cross multiply 0.4S is equal to S minus 90 rupees, or sales is equal to 150 rupees. That is, it should be 90 divided by 0.6. And this is the mathematical presentation to compute the sales value. The sales value should be 150. Then how can we derive formula to find out this answer to this question? This is one method. Or you can use formula PV ratio is equal to contribution by sales, which is equal to sales minus variable cost by sales, or it can be sales divided by sales minus variable cost by sales, which is equal to 1 minus this variable cost divided by sales. Variable cost divided by sales is known as variable cost ratio. Very, very, very important formula. What is that? PV ratio is equal to 1 minus variable cost ratio. This is very, very important. PV ratio is equal to 1 minus variable cost ratio. This can be rewritten as, or variable cost ratio is equal to 1 minus PV ratio. And what is the importance of PV ratio according to the assumptions of marginal costing? It is contribution by sales, or contribution per unit by sales, where selling price and variable cost per unit are constant, variable contribution per unit should also be a constant. According to the principles of marginal costing and its assumptions, selling price is a constant, variable cost per unit is constant. And where selling price and variable cost per unit are constant, contribution per unit should also be a constant. That is, this C is constant, this is constant, so that the PV ratio should also be a constant. That is, the PV ratio is a constant. If the PV ratio is a constant, 1 minus PV ratio, that is variable cost ratio, should also be a constant. And what is the variable cost ratio under the present case? It is variable cost divided by selling price. Variable cost per unit divided by selling price. Variable cost ratio, variable cost divided by selling price. Therefore, variable cost ratio of present case, it should be 60 by 100 into 100, that is 60%. When the PV ratio is 40%, variable cost ratio, this 60% is nothing but 100 minus PV ratio, that is 40%. Variable cost ratio should also be a constant. And when the variable cost is increased to 90 and the company wants the same PV ratio, means the variable cost ratio for the revised contribution should also be the same. That should be 60%. Therefore, 60% is equal to variable cost 90 rupees by selling price. This is the variable cost ratio. Therefore, what is S? Therefore, S is equal to 90 rupees divided by 0.6, which is equal to 150 rupees. This is how you can apply formula to find answer to the same question. Third question, the following figures are taken from a manufacturing company. The figures are taken for 2 years, year 1 and year 2. For year 1, you have total sales value and total cost. For the year 1, total sales is 22,23,000 rupees and total cost is 19,83,600 rupees. And for year 2, it is 24,51,000 sales and 21,23,200 rupees as total cost. This line is very important. Should the assumptions of marginal costing hold good? Should the assumptions of marginal costing hold good? Calculate PV ratio, total fixed cost, break-even point and margin of safety for 2 years, that is year 1 and year 2. What are the assumptions of marginal costing? It is applicable to a relevant range. Selling price is constant. Variable cost per unit is constant. Total fixed cost is constant. And these are all applicable for relevant range. These are the important assumptions of marginal cost. And what are to be computed? PV ratio. What is PV ratio? Contribution by sales into 100. Then what is break-even point? Total fixed cost divided by PV ratio. And all these are based on the assumption. You can compute PV ratio only if the sales value and contribution value is known. We have only total cost. You can apply the formula only where the total cost is divided into total variable cost and total fixed cost. But we have given only total cost. What is this total cost? It is sum of variable cost and sum of total variable cost and total fixed cost. That is, how we will divide the total cost into total variable cost and total fixed cost from the given information. That is why this question is selected. Then you may take year 1 or what is total cost? Total cost of year 1. Total cost of year 1 is equal to total variable cost of year 1 plus total fixed cost of year 1. Total variable, total cost of year 1 is equal to total variable cost of year 1 plus total fixed cost of year 1. That is, total cost of year 1 is equal to, what is total variable cost? What is the assumptions of variable cost? It is that variable cost per unit remains constant, or total variable cost is directly proportional to volume. That is, total variable cost of year 1 is equal to variable cost per unit of year 1 multiplied with volume of year 1. Total variable cost is variable cost per unit year 1 multiplied with volume, that is production of year 1, plus total fixed cost of year 1. You may take this as equation number 1. Now, similarly, what is total cost of year 2? This variable cost per unit of year 2 into volume of year 2 plus total fixed cost of year 2. Now you may apply the assumptions of marginal costing. That is, total cost of year 2 is equal to variable cost per unit of year 2. If you are applying the assumptions of marginal costing, variable cost per unit is a constant whether it is for year 1 or year. Therefore, this variable cost per unit of year 2 will be equal to variable cost per unit of year 1. Why? Because that is the assumption taken in the marginal costing, into that is to be multiplied with volume of year 2. Definitely the sales volume can be different for different years. Therefore, volume of year 2 plus, what is total fixed cost for year 2? Apply the assumptions of marginal costing. Total fixed cost remains constant. Therefore, this should be equal to total fixed cost year 1. This is formula number 2. Now, subtract year 1 figure from year 2 figure. That is, you may take 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 gives you, first you may take left hand side LHS, total cost year 2 minus total cost year 1 is equal to this one. Variable cost per unit of year 2 is nothing but that of year 1 into volume of year 2 plus total fixed cost of year 1 minus of the figure 4, equation number 1, RHS right hand side, variable cost per unit of year 1 into multiplied with the volume of year 1 plus total fixed cost of year 1. In this case, this variable cost per unit year 1, total fixed cost year 1 and total fixed cost year 1 cancels. What is left? Right hand side, this total cost year 2 minus total cost year 1 is equal to, you can take variable cost per unit as common. Variable cost per unit year 1 into, that should be multiplied with volume, changes in volume of year 2 minus volume of year 1, from which you can find out what is the variable cost per unit. Therefore, variable cost per unit year 1 is equal to total cost year 2 minus total cost year 1 whole divided by volume of year 2 minus volume of year 1. Now we have a standard formula, that is variable cost per unit is equal to, variable cost per unit is equal to change in total cost divided by change in sales volume. It can be given value, rupees, volume or changes in sales value. This is very, very, very important formula where total cost and total sales, where total cost and total sales for the two different periods are given. How can we find out variable cost per unit to divide the total cost into variable cost and fixed cost? First, you should find out variable cost per unit. What is variable cost per unit? Change in total cost divided by change in sales. That is, in the given case, we need to compute PV ratio, fixed cost, break-even point and margin of safety for the 2 years separately. And it is given, the question, it is stated that we must follow the assumptions of marginal cost. And we have only total sales value and total cost value and total sales value. Now we have the formula to find out variable cost per unit. Now, what is variable cost per unit? First step, you may find out what is variable cost per unit. Now we have the formula, it is change in total cost divided by change in sales. Variable cost per unit, we already derived the formula. Variable cost per unit is equal to change in total cost. This delta is the change, gives you the change in total cost divided by delta total cost by delta sales. It is the change in total cost divided by change in sales, which is equal to, what is the change in total cost? 21,43,200 minus 19,83,600. Change in total cost 21,43,200 minus 19,83,600 whole divided by change in sales 24,51,000 minus 22,23,000, and the answer is 0.7. That is, this variable cost per unit is nothing but variable cost ratio, which is equal to the variable cost ratio. If the variable cost ratio is given, we can find out PV ratio. Variable cost ratio is equal to 0.7. Profit volume ratio, PV ratio, is equal to 1 minus variable cost ratio, which is equal to 1 minus 0.7, which is equal to 0.3, or this PV ratio is equal to 40%. Variable cost ratio 0.7 means it is 70%, so that this PV ratio is 40%. And the questions state that the assumption should be called good, that is, the selling price and variable cost remains constant. Since the selling price and variable cost for the 2 years are constant, the contribution and the PV ratio should also be a constant for the 2 years. Total fixed cost. Total cost, take year one, you may take year one. Total cost is equal to total variable cost plus total fixed cost. Total cost is equal to total variable cost plus total fixed cost. What is total variable cost? When sales figure and PV ratio are given, total variable cost is equal to sales value into variable cost ratio plus total fixed cost. And total cost for year 1 is given, it is rupees 19,83,600, which is equal to total variable cost. What is total variable cost for year 1? Sales for the year 1 multiplied with the variable cost ratio. It is 22,23,000 rupees into 70% plus total fixed cost, that is to be found out. Therefore, total fixed cost is equal to 4,27,500. 4,27,500. Now, what is the total fixed cost for year 2? This is the total fixed cost for year 1. And the question states, the assumptions of marginal costing are holding good. If so, what is total fixed cost for year 2? Same, there is no change. It should be 4,27,500. 4,27,500. That is, we have PV ratio for the 2 year. PV ratio is, since the variable cost ratio is 70%, PV ratio is 30% for year. And if, since the selling price and the contribution are same for the 2 years, the PV ratio for year 2 will be same as that of year 1, that is 40%. Similarly, total fixed cost for year 1 is computed as 4,27,000. Again, the question says that the marginal costing assumptions are valid, so that for year 2 should also be 4,27,500. Now, what about break-even point year 1? Formula is total fixed cost divided by PV ratio. Total fixed cost we already computed, it is equal to 4,27,500 divided by, and we computed the PV ratio as 30%. Therefore, the break-even point for year 1, break-even point for the year 1 is 14,21,500. 14,25,000. Now, what about break-even point for year 2? If the assumptions of marginal costing are hold good, same is same as that of year 1 is equal to 14,25,000. That is break even point same. Now what about margin of safety? Next is margin of safety year 1, year 2, actual sales year 1 22,23,000 and that of year 2 24,51,000. Break even sales for year 1 14,25,000 and year 2 same 14,25,000. Therefore, margin of safety for year 1 is 7,98,000 and for year 2 10,26,000. That is margin of safety. What is margin of safety? Actual sales minus break-even sales. Actual sales for year 1 22,23,000 minus break-even sales 14,25,000, resulting in 7,98,000. Similarly, that for year 2 24,51,000 minus 14,25,000 is 10,26,000.